What's up, everyone? Thanks for tuning in.
In this episode, I'll talk about the amazing flower pot corals and how to keep them in a captive environment. Everyone knows that Goniopora are impossible to keep. They always die after a year or so. That's the word on the street. But it's not the whole truth. Personally, I took this statement as a challenge and set out to change the way we looked at the care of this impossible coral. Until recently, I dare not say I have cracked the code on many Goniopora species. I have kept both Alveopora and Goniopora, and most of them have seen substantial growth in the past 18 months. I can now tell that it is possible to keep Goniopora alive as long as you provide the proper care and feeding for the species in question. Captive grown species grow faster and are hardier than wild collected colonies. Not only has the coral itself adapted to captivity, but the bacteria, zooxanthellae, and other symbiotic organisms have also adapted. The Goniopora, daisy, or flower pot corals have been common imports from Indonesia and other regions since the early years of the reef keeping hobby. Alveopora are less frequently harvested relatives of Goniopora. These distinct genera are often grouped together by aquarists because they have similarly elongate polyps with daisy-like heads. However, the petal-like tentacles in Goniopora number 24, in Alveopora there are just 12. These corals have both charmed and frustrated aquarists for years. I too have experienced the agony of failure with these corals, but very fortunately, I eventually saved a colony that was once on decline due to insufficient feeding. In my opinion, it is wrong to generalize that all Goniopora are difficult to keep. There are numerous species, and they behave differently in captivity. I find that certain species of Goniopora are easy to keep, contrary to popular belief, and that most Alveopora are similarly hardy. As the saying goes, success leads us to stop learning, and only a perceived failure causes it to start again. I have done numerous experiments since this colony was found on decline, including adjustment of chemicals and nutrient levels, improvement of lighting and flow, placement on various substrates, trial of live and artificial food, and of different brands. It turned out that phytoplankton, no matter live or artificial, was the single dominant factor that affected survival of this species in the long run. The energy the symbiotic algae provided was simply not enough to meet its day-to-day needs. The symptoms of slow decline were really a sign of starvation. As soon as I dosed the green water, the live phytoplankton I cultured separately, the polyps extended back up again in just a week's time. Live phyto came with nutrients that would potentially contaminate the tank. Hence, I replaced the live phyto with bright whale phyto gold and phyto green instead. Tropic marine phyton is also good, but it contains more nutrients than bright whale equivalents. It is worth mentioning that zooplankton, such as live rotifers, did not save it from decline. nor did amino acids, such as Red Sea Reef Energy AB. Having said that, this captive bred species was not sensitive to feeding. It seemed to be able to gain enough energy from photosynthesis alone. But frequent feeding did improve its growth rate of both polyps and skeleton. It has tripled its size since I purchased it a year ago, when I was impressed by its vibrant color. Certain species can extend almost 10 times in length as the size of their skeletons. This Alveopora became very small at night, but looked entirely different in the day when it extended all its polyps. Consequently, you need to measure the fully extended size before you finalize your purchase decision. Another concern is the compatibility. Although most species are compatible with each other, it's better you check the compatibility list before purchasing. As a rule of thumb, Goniopora are more aggressive with sweeper tentacles than Alveopora. But again, there's no guarantee. If you have any questions or suggestions regarding flower pot corals, please feel free to drop a comment below and I'll be happy to answer them. Subscribe to my YouTube channel to get the latest updates, and thanks for watching.